did as we are.
That really got us then.
Was it the montage, Kimberly? The montage worked a treat.
Well, yeah. we don't hear the songs like after each other like that very often.
It makes you feel it good. So, yeah.
It does. You've got all the goosebumps. Can we say hello to one of the best female bands in the world ever? Quintessential British treasure. Someone described you as. Oh. Girls Aloud.
Good morning.
How are you? Are you excited?
Yes, so excited.
Yeah, I can see your eyes are all twinkling. How long have you had to sit on the secret about being back together?
Months and months. We didn't tell our closest friends, our families didn't know.
I mean, it's probably not been as long as it feels.
It feels like forever, doesn't it?
Even this week since we started off the, you know, when Nicola, you put out the
best
Instagram
teaser
thing, and then it was like, everyone's like, what's going on? I know something's going on. Like, don't ask. Just don't. I've been ignoring everybody all week.
You just have to ignore all the texts, Nadine, in case people are asking.
Avoiding people
and you're
on the school run.
Like, eyes down. Don't make eye contact. Yeah. Blinkers on. This is so, so fantastic. By the way, Kimberly, happy birthday.
Oh, and you,
Scorpio.
Happy birthday.
Flowers. What a treat. Richie was like, it's your birthday and you've got Girls Aloud in.
Yay!
It's so exciting. Can I just say, Richie came in and he said how you all smelt divine. He's so right. You are like a meadow.
Nice.
It's fabulous. So you're getting back together for this tour. I mean, this is incredible. How was that moment when you all just said, yeah, now's the time. Let's go for it. Once you knew it was a big yes.
It's a crazy experience because we've obviously had so many amazing songs and so many amazing times together. And then the conversation had come up kind of around the summertime, you know, should we do something, you know? And we've obviously feel so passionate about it. But then when you start looking at things and agreeing at things, then all of a sudden, it was a few weeks ago, we were shooting the commercial for the tour and we were looking at each other.
It was so fast.
Yeah. Why is this? How did we end up here?
Yeah.
What is happening? It felt very 2002 Sound of the Underground video era.
It really felt like over the past sort of couple of years, we've just felt this like massive outpouring of love towards us, and it's been like pulling us in. Like, obviously, it's been so tough, and then it felt like, okay, we're feeling this love and maybe we do need to do something to celebrate, you know?
It's quite hard to explain as well, but between us, we just feel something that
there's
we didn't
shift.
Necessarily... Yeah, there's been a shift. So it feels like a bit of a magical let's
time,
go.
Yeah.
Well, you're probably right as well because, you know, you all went off and everyone had separate adventures and everything, and then and losing Sarah as well. And then suddenly when you start to feel that sort of pull back together... And obviously all the fans are like, please do it. You know what you want to do. And every time any of you are interviewed individually, it's the question everybody asks.
That's been for 10
and
years.
And that's what we want. When are you getting back together? Is it going to happen? Yeah. So the fans are absolutely thrilled. Are you bowled over by the response already?
Yes.
I feel we're so fortunate to have the fans we have, and their loyalty is off the... I've never experienced anything like it. I mean,
no.
21 years later,
how
we're getting new fans.
21 years.
That's crazy, isn't it?
And you all look fabulous. I'll be getting this.
We have been up for a long time doing hair and makeup, just to let you know. This is not going to wake up like this.
Thank you. We're going to play a song. I have so many questions for you girls. We'll talk about the tour. We'll talk about your plans. We'll talk about this video that you've been spotted making as well. Something about superheroes? How gorgeous is that? Ray, worth it. Girls Aloud loving a bit of Ray this morning. The girls are here, and how happy are we to have them here? Kimberly is here. It's been her birthday. Were you spoiled? Did you get nice prezzies?
I did, you know. I got some really lovely stuff. And, you know, my kids are all nice to me all day on my birthday. I love it.
For the whole day.
Yes.
Cheryl, how are you, darling? Are you good? How's Bear?
Delicious.
Oh.
Yeah, not so baby anymore.
Not so baby.
No.
You'll blink and it'll be driving.
I feel like I just blinked and we're here, nearly 7.
Yeah, well, this is the bonkers thing, isn't it? Nadine was just talking about being scammed on TikTok.
At least once.
Be careful.
I probably ordered other things that I forgot that I've ordered.
Yes.
I'm a real sucker for those things.
Okay, right, fantastic.
That's not...
Don't start, Nicola. If you haven't started, don't start.
No, yes.
I'm not a TikToker yet.
You're not a TikToker yet.
No, you're missing
Save
out.
Yourself.
I like the question mark on the end of that, yeah. The exclamation yeah. mark, yeah. yet, dot, dot, dot. Yeah. If you're going on tour, you're going to be TikToking.
Probably.
There'll be time to fill in between.
Get that
shows.
Promo in there.
Exactly. The Girls Aloud Show Arena Tour dates. It's been announced. Kicking off on the 18th of May next year.
Nice.
Running till the 29th of June, going all over the place. Dublin, Belfast, Manchester, Cardiff, Newcastle, Aberdeen, Glasgow, Nottingham, Leeds, Birmingham, London, two nights at the O2,
yes.
And Liverpool as well. How much is planned already? What discussions have been had?
Regarding the show.
Yeah. Regarding the show.
We've had initial meetings.
Okay.
But we haven't set anything in stone yet.
And we usually, those initial meetings, we need to be reined right back in.
Oh, right. Yeah. Because we're just like, we want to fly. We want to come out on this.
Yeah,
and we
want to
be shut out on the stage.
And you know who needed more reining on? The creative director. First meeting, she was really going for it. We were doing some wild things and we were like, okay,
Beth. She's always been our creative director. Yeah. We've got all our OJ crew.
Yes.
All the team is exactly the same people, so which is wonderful. It's part of our makeup. It's part of the magic.
Mm-hmm.
But she especially is bursting with excitement to get going. And we're like, might want to rein that one in.
But then you know what happens. Then it comes to it and we just want it to be like the most amazing, biggest show it can possibly be. And we're like, let's do it. Uh-huh.
We can do trapeze. Yeah. We could be flying trapeze.
Yeah.
We could be lowered.
She got to the end of her little speech and she was like, so are you happy? And I was like, well, I love how high your ceiling is.
We were shocked. We're like, okay.
Okay. But this is the thing. It is a long time in the coming. So,
it
you
is.
Know, you can go for it,
yeah.
can't you?
We have to.
We always do. Gerbelard, we've been known for that. Like the many tours that we've done where we've flown over, landed on another stage, then flown back, or on one of the tours we got onto the B stage and then ran through the arena backwards to get to the dressing room. I mean, we really just really are gluttons for punishment, but we're all about the entertainment. It's all about the vibe.
But you can do that in crazy heels and very tight outfits.
I mean, you say that.
You could.
Heels is a real big discussion we're having at the moment.
Well, the pandemic has destroyed the heel industry. I think everyone's in flats.
Yes.
We've all got to go up again.
All right, so it's the pandemic. It's not age at all. It's the pandemic.
That's what it is. Can I just say so many messages? Hi, Zoe. So excited about the Girls Lab being on The Breakfast Show this morning. I used to do primary school skipping club routines to their songs. And I'll stand by you at every disco. This is Ben.
Gorgeous Ben.
Thank you, Ben.
Another Richie. This could be ours, but maybe not. I'm so excited Girls Aloud are back. I've been with my boyfriend for the last 9 years. He has never experienced me in an actual
Uh-oh.
Girls Aloud era.
He's about to say a whole new level.
He says,
Richie,
I'm not sure he's ready.
He's not.
That could well be from Richie and Dean.
I was going to say, I just saw Richie. It could be from him.
He is on the phone as we speak.
Is he on the phone to Dean or are you trying to book your ticket? Girls Aloud, whoop whoop, that is all. Love you girls. That's Kaz in Reddit.
Love you Kaz.
The internet has gone crazy for you. So I just must say, tickets go on sale next Friday morning at 9.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The pre-sale.
Yeah, it's the pre-sale today at girlsaloud.com. So
okay.
Then you can get yourself in the queue.
Possibly a good
get
idea.
In the queue. Yeah, and then I think pre-sale, and then it's Wednesday, and then general sale, the 1st of December. So not long.
Not long. Rylan, who we're going to FaceTime in a minute because he loves you and has been hysterical. And he's been messaging you, hasn't he?
Sorry, Rylan, I just couldn't reply. At the nth or the last hour, I didn't want to just ruin it. I know, Rylan, that you wouldn't ruin it, but if it was my fault that it snuck out, my life would not be worth living.
Exactly.
I just stayed stum.
Well, he said a question he wanted answered was there was a rumour that you had been spotted in superhero outfits.
Gosh.
That was just our day-to-day. That's just
something.
How we look, so interesting.
So was that a video?
No,
for
so
any...
we shot an advert, which is now live. That was that was our tour commercial.
Ah, right.
And the tour poster outfits, you could say they're slightly...
They're superhero.
I mean,
elements.
I think they'd be interpreted by a man who wasn't interested in fashion as superhero outfits.
Rylan.
But to any fashionista out there, you'd say, oh, they're like Cher catsuits or Diana Ross jumpsuits.
Love it.
You know?
Okay, so this is another important question.
That's more the reference we were going for.
I like it. Yeah. Okay, that's it. Now, but now we know, you see.
Yeah,
but also, will there be new music?
No, there's no new music right now.
We have so many songs.
Okay, yes.
So many things that even to try to decide a set list for our show is almost impossible. We've got so many songs. So we want to do those first.
And sorry, then, Cheryl's having an incident with us.
We've got a droopy mic.
She's holding it. This conversation must not be taken.
It's a good job you're the little one of the group.
And it is. Just, what have you done to it? She's broken the equipment. Okay, there you heard it. No new music.
No.
For now. Talking about a revolution. It's 8:55. Girls Aloud are in the studio, as is super fan Richie Anderson.
Yay!
Richie!
Morning.
He's playing it so cool right now.
It's like a meet and greet. I can't believe this. Okay. We're going to start in County Durham on the A1M. The northbound side, one lane out at the moment between 60 and 61. That's because of an accident on the M62 eastbound. It's slow at the moment between 26 and 27. The M1 south closed because there's wood on the road in Daventry at Junction 16. And the Black Country in Bilston, Wellington Road. Sorry. It's closed because of a collapsed manhole. That's on Wolverhampton Street. Stacey's been on in Staffordshire. Pardon?
You're not coming up for air.
I know, sorry. In Staverton, the A449 is blocked, and that's because of an accident near the Oval. And finally, on the M4 on the eastbound side, one lane out. That's because of an accident between 4 for Heathrow Airport and 3. You're up to date, Girls Aloud.
Very important news.
Richie, have you got a question for Girls Aloud? Excellent. I feel like I'm in the hot seat on Live and Kicking.
Again. I know.
Oh, yeah, Live and Kicking. Oh, my God.
Live and Kicking. Have you got a question for Girls?
Yeah, first, I just want to say thank you for making my gay Christmas come true. Thank you. Can you remember all the routines?
We're about to have a refresh.
Well, I can teach you after, it's fine. Perfect. I've got them all down.
That'd be great.
He's not even joking. Thank you, Richie. I thought you held that together. Richie. Very, very cool there.
Very informative.
Are you coming?
Excellent.
Yeah, I'm already in the queue.
He is in the queue. And he does know all the routines. When will you start rehearsals, by the way?
I think it'll be like April-ish.
Yeah, it's like a month, isn't it?
Yeah.
So is that all you do? That's a month and you learn all of that.
Well, I personally feel like we need more, but these guys are like, no, it'll be fine. Memory. Just a month.
Yeah, I guess muscle memory.
Maybe I might need extra tuition.
Oh, well, if you hear your records come on when you're out and about, do you sort of have to stop yourself going into the next step?
I'm probably mentally, and then physically remove myself.
I get fully invited out. Yeah, same. I think me and Nadine are the same. We just get dragged in like a wedding. The song comes on, everyone pulls you on. You're like, yeah, come on then.
I get embarrassed.
Cheryl's like, I'm out.
Where's the car?
If you're in a shop and then they put your song on, I'm just like, I'm going to put this lipstick down and I'm going to walk backwards out of the store.
Do that then.
And leave.
I love that. You see, it just shows how different you all are, the way you react. Okay, we're going to play I'll Stand By You, Girls Aloud, with us until the end of the show at 9:30. Messages off the scale for you this morning, girls. Everyone's so happy. Having such a lovely chat with the girls in the studio. Amy on the Wirral says it's incredible to hear Girls Aloud this morning. My heart is so full. Oh. Can't wait to see them on tour next year.
I keep getting chills every time I hear a message.
Oh, more magic from the girls on the way.
Nine.
Thank you, Tina. We are putting the world to rights in here, aren't we, girl?
We've covered this. This is a whole other show we should do another time.
Honestly, this is great. We've done glowing skincare. I've been talking about the menopause.
Basically, women's hour.
We've been talking about men and women and all sorts. This is so kids growing up. What to expect is marvellous. Girls Aloud with us.
On BBC Radio 2.
More magic coming up. It's all right. You can chat. We can chat. Anyway, what were we saying?
Right. I was thinking, is that one of our songs?
I don't recognise the sting.
It's the jingle. But you can have it if you want for a small fee. Rihanna, only girl in the world. If you've just tuned into The Breakfast Show, well, quite frankly, where have you been? We have Girls Aloud with us. They are back together to go on tour next year. The Girls Aloud show. We're all a bit hysterical. It's so joyous. We're having a good old gossip and a catch-up. Girls Aloud, little 16-year-old me, is screaming, the loveliest surprise this morning, says Emma in Bolton. Sarah in Essex says, can't wait for the tour. We took our daughter to see the girls. her first concert, she was only 8.
Oh, that's so cute.
She's now 22. Her name is Lucy. Fingers crossed we're going to get tickets to relive the magic of that night with her. See, that's a lovely thing, isn't it? You get generations coming as well to see you. And your kids will be able to see you.
Yes. They're very excited about this.
Are the family excited, Kimberly?
Well, they haven't really cared up until now about Girls Aloud. It was like, that was before we were born. We're not interested. And then suddenly when everyone else starts to get interested, they picked up. And then Bobby this morning was like, so it's today. I can tell all my friends at school. Oh, like, he's been holding it in so long. And
I certainly wouldn't have, because the whole school would have known by the half an hour later.
Well, that's the thing. You go straight into the playground and you share your gossip.
You know, my mummy's doing stuff with her friends. Yeah. He's one of them. But I haven't said a thing. He watched recently, actually, the BBC played Tangled Up. And we were watching it in a group. We were chatting in a group chat while we were watching it.
Yeah.
And Bear was lying next to me watching bits, you know, ear wigging and looking at my phone and whatever. And then all of a sudden he went, "Mummy, may I ask, why all the nakedness?"
And I was like, little.
And then he cringed, and then I was a bit like, "Oh God!" And then he was curious as to why Kimberly was there, what she was doing, why did we look and sound different now? And, it was very humbling experience.
They tend to do that, kids. Yeah. They're a real knack of humbling.
Well, I love that they cut straight through all the niceties. Tell you how it is.
Yeah. Always hold on to that.
Will they come to the shows?
Yeah,
they will be.
We're not going to get away with that.
Right? Yeah, will they be on stage? I mean, would that happen?
I mean, I'm going to have to try and fight mine off, I think. Certainly the old. But I don't know, really. We'll work it out. I think what's going to be really cute is, like, they spent a bit of time together, didn't they, over the summer, your birthday, and they're like a little crew now. So even that to me just makes my heart just go to the thought of them all watching us together. Because, like Cheryl said, it's just like we're just friends.
Auntie
they don't
Kimberly,
really get it.
Yeah, they don't get it at
they
all.
They can all have their little AAA passes.
And then Nicholas decided that we should have a family bus.
I agree with that. We should all have one.
We're in this together.
With some earplugs. Having fun and like having champagne, and we were like putting babies to bed, like, good night.
Yeah, you've got to all mix it up. Maybe have the option to go on the other bus if you need a rest. Because, you know.
But they're all so sweet too, so it'll be so exciting to have them and such a good memory to have
Nicola,
them there with us.
Nicola can stay on the corn bus. We'll have the family bus, and then we'll just drip feed other kids when we're tired.
Yeah.
Tonight's Auntie Nicola's night.
I'll get on the bus one night and it'll just be kids everywhere, and I'd be like, oh my God,
you'll be getting text messages.
I love it.
It's your night.
They always say the apple.
You're already halfway down the motorway on your free kid bus.
They always say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. Are you seeing, you know, talent there? Are you seeing sort of young singers, actors?
Absolutely. We've got no really hope. Like, she is heading
the irony of how much I've tried for this to not happen.
So true.
You can't.
And he is the one bursting at the seams. He's just full of it, isn't he?
He's a little performer, like, he's just there. We've got a boy band between us, to be honest, already.
Yeah, sorted.
And then I'll have to just come in and do a bit of lead vocals for us now and again.
They could do a collab. That would be lovely. Love it. If you have questions for the girls, 88291 on the text. We might have to get a young fan of yours, Rylan, on the phone. I did promise him. These wings are made to Little Mix and Wings, chosen by Kimberly to play today. Yes. You've just been talking about the girls.
Yeah, do you know what? I love the girls, and I love that they gave us that little shout-out at the Brits. I thought that was just real, proper girl power, women supporting women, which is what we're all about. So, yeah, love you girls.
Love you.
Love them to bits. And Nicola, you've written for them as well.
Songs for them.
Are you writing for anyone at the moment, or are you going to be concentrating on the tour?
I'm not at the moment. Okay. This is very much taken up all of my time. It's so good. People don't see the behind the scenes as well as like the references that we pull from, and who are we going to use for styling, who are we going to use for photography, so that's taken up like a big chunk.
And I love the fact that you girls are involved in all the stages here, because it's you go out there, you need, from the beginning, don't you, from the conception, it's always been the way you are.
It has always been
the way. And there's always been that
the thought that girl bands that we just, you know, you don't know what's going on, you're pulled from pillar to post, and we were like, we could do way a bit of that. Yeah. We've had to do everything ourselves. Yeah. These people get everything done for them. That was not our experience at all.
So. Oh. Also, lots of eagle-eyed fans have spotted there is a slight gap in the tour date schedule. Glastonbury. Annie, looking to see if I can get
Can I just be blunt? Yeah. Oh, Glastonbury haven't even asked us a stick.
Okay.
I don't even know if they
would
want us
to pick, but and I don't even know if it's feasible. I haven't looked at the dates. We just need them to ask us.
There we go. Ask the question.
It's out there, guys.
There we go. Emily, sorted out.
I'm sure the Glastonbury lot are sitting there like,
hang on, who's not made that call?
Exactly.
Maybe Ellen should just turn up with our bus and demand that we can
Now, I did promise that we would. Nana here, do I press video, Jamie? We're going to video call a dear friend of yours and ours. Am I doing that one? Am I pressing that? I said I'd FaceTime him. He said if I didn't FaceTime him, he'd die. And he's got a host. This morning today, so we're hopefully going to hook up live with there he is, Ryan!
Hello!
Who are you hosting with today?
It's me and Alison today. So you're lucky I've just put my trousers on.
I'm glad you did that just for us.
How disappointing. You're looking beautiful, Rylan, by the way. You sent me a message last night. I didn't quite understand it. I got it now. It's like, Nana, keep up. What's your question for the girls? Have you been listening, by the way? I asked about the superheroes.
Yeah. I've got all our questions. You know what? Girls, I haven't actually got a question for you. I just want to say two things to you. One, I don't normally speak on behalf of other people, but on behalf of the gays, welcome back. I might get in trouble with this because I work on Radio 2, but I want justice for Untouchable. I want to get Untouchable in the top 10.
Okay.
Nice, yeah. I like that.
Good one, good choice.
So I'm just putting it out there now. Everyone listening, go stream, go download Untouchable. We're going to get the girls Untouchable.
Love that. Love that.
And we are so glad you're back.
Thanks, Rylan.
Lovely to see you.
We love you, Rylan. Okay, we'll do that now. I'll do it now. Get it in the schedule. We'll sort that out. Thank you. We're going to play Mariah first. Love you, darling. How do I hang up?
Bye.
What do I do? Can you help Nana here? Some more amazing messages for you. It's my birthday this week. The Girls Aloud News is the best present ever. Thank you, see you on tour from Ellen.
Happy birthday, Ellen.
And Zoe says, hi Zoe, my husband Daryl is 49 and his friend Tim a lifelong Girls Aloud fan. Suffice to say he's so excited this morning. This is a 454 on the text. There are millions of these. I could read these all the way till Vernon. Gary in Tamworth, Girls Aloud, my teens and 20s, I'm so so happy to have him back. My heart is bursting today. It's huge. Right, we're going to play Mariah and then we will find that song for you. We'll find Unstoppable. No, we're not going to play Mariah. We're going to play Cher.
Untouchable.
We'll find it. Especially, I know, Nana. I'm such a Nana. Look, my glasses have steamed up. Are you a Nana too?
Big Nana.
Oh, honestly, I'm in good company, see. Share strong enough. It's so lovely to see you girls like together. Just gossip. It's so much. It's so fabulous. You don't stop. It's so. I love it. It's brilliant. I wish we could actually just put the whole thing out on the air because the gossip off air.
We couldn't do that.
So many people saying, you know, we can't talk to you, lovely girls, without mentioning wonderful Sarah.
Yes.
And it will be strange for you to perform together without her, I imagine, when you go on tour.
Every step of this process, honestly, since we decided, has been weird, to be honest.
Yeah. Even right now.
Right now
even
is weird.
Even sitting here, because there's usually Sarah having so much to say or deciding that she doesn't want to say anything that day. We're like, I don't want it. So just you have that whole huge muscle element of her not being here.
I mean, when we started discussing doing this, we actually started these discussions with Sarah.
Exactly. Yeah.
Because obviously the 20-year anniversary was pending. We all knew it was coming. So we started having those conversations with her included. So the fact that we're here now and she isn't here is
heartbreaking, yeah. honestly. Yeah, if I'm honest, it's never going to be the same.
No, I know.
But we're going to do our very best to keep it magical and keep her magic alive and her
keep
twinkle.
Her energy,
she'll be very much a part of the show. And it's for her, it's she was, you know, the part of our makeup for 20 years, and that's not going anywhere. She'll be there in spirit on the stage.
Yeah,
she'll be there.
We're going to celebrate
her.
Yeah,
we're going to celebrate her.
And also, just listening to you talk, it's, you know, I have friends, you know, we've lost friends in a similar way. And that's the thing, you keep the spirit of them alive in your love and your memories, and they are always with you. And you know that, you know, she'd be like, go, girls.
Yeah,
get them, go, do it.
She absolutely would.
You know, and thank you so much for doing lots for, you know, cancer charities, breast cancer charities as well, because, you know, it's important to do
it
what you can and support,
isn't it?
And that's
something that we're committed to continue to do as well. And it's been an amazing driving force.
We're really proud, actually, of what we've been able to contribute
so far,
to.
Yeah.
So, yeah, let's keep that going.
Bless you, girls. And, yeah, no, thank you for sharing that as well. OK, we'll be back with the girls.
Say, M25, what's going on? Yeah, anti-clockwise side. One lane out. She's always stuck in traffic, that one. Just after 14 for Heathrow. That's because of a break. And you were to date.
Oh,
yay.
I know.
Cheryl
was doing that, like, the whole Cheryl doing things like the air hostess there as well. And the traffic's going to the right and the traffic's going to the left. Oh, girls, it has been an absolute joy.
It's been such a pleasure.
Thanks for coming to share it with us.
Thank you.
Tickets go on sale. Can you believe it? For the girls, a loud show. The best news ever.
The best show ever.
Oh, it's going to be such an amazing show. I want to hear more about what your plans are. Off air. Next Friday morning at 9, that's when they go on sale. But the pre-sale is from Wednesday morning at 9. Might want to get yourself in that because it's going to be busy.
You can sign up to get in the queue today, which is exciting, at girlsaloud.com. So you don't have to do, you don't have to be a sitting duck. You can go
for it. Take action immediately. And if you want to hear more Girls Aloud, search Girls Aloud on BBC Sounds. Loads of special programmes. Lovely Ollie Alexander talking about his favourite tracks.
Oh, we love him.
Isn't
so
it? Oh, he's a joy. He loves you as
he's
well.
He's texted me this one.
He's texted me.
You contributed to this.
Oh, what's he said?
He's just so excited, literally about 10 messages
and
in
you know,
a row.
He was such a support for all gala and stuff like that. He's just an amazing person.
Really,
we're very grateful.
When we asked him to do the gala, he then came with his backing singers. He planned all
the
choreography.
He's like ready to go. He's the most
he's a good
beautiful
soul. He put on a proper show for everyone.
I love you. Great artist, supporting great artists. It's amazing. Now for Rylan, we've got 30 seconds of this. Make Ryland's wish come true. Everybody stream it. Girls, joyous to see you.
So lovely.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank
we cannot
so
wait to see it on the road. Thank you for sharing with us.
Thanks.
Girls alive.
Thank you. Well, and happy birthday, Zoe.
Thank you for my flowers. Hello, $6 million man.
Morning.
How are you? It's Fern and Kay. You raised $6 million for children.
Oh, fantastic.
How are you, Fern?
I'm still absolutely shattered. I ain't gonna lie.
Shall I send the girls in to cheer you up with a slice of cake?
Oh, cake would be lovely.
Okay.
Yeah,
cake.
I'm absolutely exhausted.
I know you are.
I really am goosed.
Who decided to come to work this week, though?
Some clone.
I know. What a fool you are. Bless you. I'm sending the girls in to see you, darling. Have a good show.
See you in a bit.
Lots of love. Bye.